So, welcome out to the building site. Today, my job is to cut a pattern rafter so that I can construct a gable roof on this little shed that we're going to construct. So, the dimensions of the shed, as you can see, 5 meters 920 long and 3 meters 920 wide. That's the overall dimensions from the outside of the brickwork. The outside of brickwork. So the first thing we need to work out for our pattern rafter is what our span of our roof is. So if we have a look at a plan view, because this is a brick veneer construction, we actually have to deduct 110 mil for our brickwork, and then a further 40 mil for our cavity. So effectively we have to deduct 150 mil off this side and 150 mil off this side to give us our span of our roof, which in this case will be 3 meters 620. Once we've got that, we can halve it, which will give us our half span. So our half span for this roof will be 1810, or 1 meter 810. Okay, so that gives us our half span. That's the first thing we need. We then need, obviously, we need to know what pitch of our roof is. And in this case, our pitch is going to be 30 degrees. So we can then use the formula tan roof pitch, which in this case is 30, times by our half span, which in this case is 1810, will give us a rise of our roof of 1 meter and 45. So half span, do the Pythagoras, or sorry, do the formula, and you'll get a rise of 1 meter and 45. So that's known as the half span, 1810, rise, 1 meter 45. So using this later on, we can actually work out what the length of our common rafter is. And similarly, we also need to work out what our length of our eave overhang is. Now in this case, we had a 450 eave width on our plan, but because it's brick veneer, we've effectively, well, one thing we've got to add that 150 mil on. So 450 plus 150 is going to give us 600. And we can then work out what this distance here is, which is what we call the drop-off. And we're not going to need that for these calculations today, but which is commonly used so we can work out where our brickwork's going to finish, and also so we can put our window heads and that sort of thing into our walls. All right, same formula, okay, except this time we're using the eave width, this dimension here, as instead of our half span, and we can get the rise. Okay, so that's the information we need to know. Now the other thing, if you want to put your bevels onto a steel square, we can then use the formula tan times the roof pitch. So that's tan 30, gives us 577. And of course, 577 won't fit on the tongue of the square. We divide that by 2, so that gives us 289. So we put 289 on the square there. We have 500 on here because that's half a meter. Because when we do tan 30, that's based on a meter of run. So 500's half that. Okay, 289's half of 577. So effectively, we've created the same triangle of the same proportions onto the steel square. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to get our timber, decide what the actual timber we need to cut the rafters out of. So the best way to do that, once again, now we have all this information, we can use Pythagoras. So we know that our half span was 1 meter 810. We know that our rise was 1 meter and 45. So we can simply use Pythagoras to work out what the actual length of that rafter was. We then also have to do the same process with our overhang. So Pythagoras, our eave width, remember adding the 150 mil. And we can then work out what our overhang distance was, and we can add those two together to give us an actual length of 2 meters 782. Now we're going to cut angles on both ends of the rafter, so we can allow 100 mil for cutting the angles. So that gets us up to 2 meters 982, and we've got to order orderable lengths, so we'll just round that up to 3 meters. So we're going to order 3 meter lengths. The alternative to doing it that way, if you like, is to use cos. And the way we use cos, we take our half span and we divide it by cos and then the roof pitch, in this case 30. So half span was 1810 divided by cos 30 gave us the same answer, 2 meters and 90. Do the same for the overhang. So instead of over, half span should be eaves width divided by cos and the roof pitch will give us the answer. So 600 divided by cos 30 gives us 692 millimeters. Add them together, and again, we end up with a 3 meter length of timber. So we've got our 3 meter length of timber. So the next step, where we want to start up at the ridge. So we're going to take our steel square. Now you could quite easily use a sliding bevel, set it whatever your roof pitch had to be, whatever method you want to use to get your angle. I'm going to use steel square because we can show you a couple of things with it. But you could use a sliding bevel or whatever you want to get your these bevels with. So I'm going to start with a sliding bevel, and I'm actually going to draw in just a line across here, make it a dotted line, because this is not going to be a line that you cut. It's just somewhere to start your set out. Now the unique thing with the steel square is I don't actually need to know what this distance along here is. All I need to know is my half span, so I can actually read across the square from here across 500, put a mark, and then I can move the square down. Okay, so there's my center line. I've come down 500, go down another 500. All right, so we've got a meter, another 500, we're down to 1500, and on the last step, we see our half span was 1810. We go, instead of going 500, we go 310, and that gives us the back of our bird's mouth. We don't even need to know what dimension that was. You can, if you do know, and we do know because we've worked it out, we actually know that that dimension there is 2 meters and 90. So there's no reason why you can't just mark your center line of your ridge, center line of your roof, measure that all the way down, and then just draw that angle in with, again, your sliding bevel or whatever it is you're using to get your angle. Okay, so we've got the back of the bird's mouth marked. So the next thing we need to do is we need to draw in our bird's mouth. Now the maximum depth of our bird's mouth is one third the width of the timber. So we break the timber up into these widths, okay, three equal widths, and with this being a 90 mil piece of timber, they're going to be 30 mil each. Okay, and we can then transfer that along to where it intersects with our back of our bird's mouth line, and effectively there, that dimension there is about 34 mil. Okay, so you can go less, but the maximum is one third the width of the timber. Okay, so once we've got that there, we can then draw in a line along here on the level bevel, and that will give us the top of our bird's mouth, like such. Okay, once we've done that, we can then worry about our overhang. So in this case, our overhang was 600 mil on the plan length. So with the steel square, we can just mark out 600 mil. And once again, there's no reason why we can't measure it. We did work that dimension out. If we go back to our calcs, it should be 692 mil. So we could measure from back of the bird's mouth down the rake 692 mil and come up with the same point. Okay, so we've got that all marked in. We then need to go back up to the top of our roof. So here we've got the center line of our roof, but we have to deduct half the thickness of our ridge, so otherwise the rafter won't fit. So we've got to come square off our original line, whatever that dimension happens to be. It could be 10 mil, could be more. Once again, you can use the steel square or your sliding bevel or whatever to mark that shortening and end up with a line like that. Okay, so now we've done that. The next step is just to go and cut all our marks. So we have to cut it off here where our ridge shortening is. We're going to have to cut out our bird's mouth. Get rid of that line. Cut out our bird's mouth and cut our overhang off. Now, sometimes we leave the overhang depending on what fascia we're going to use. If you're going to use a timber fascia, generally you're better off to leave the overhang and cut it off to a string line later. But if you're going to use a metal fascia, which has got the adjustable clips, then there's no reason you can cut that off at this point. So we cut off our rafter, and there we have a pattern rafter that we can now go and use to mark out the remaining rafter. So that's all you need to do for a gable roof. There are a couple more steps for a hip roof. We actually have to mark out where our crown end and our creepers are cut off, but we'll cover those in another video.